I'm Roger Wagner, President and Superintendent of Victor Valley College. This is the first of what I hope to be many opportunities for me to share events, activities, and issues that are important to the college and the community it serves. Let me start by thanking our faculty and staff from the Communications Department for making this video message possible. We are now several weeks into the fall semester, and I hope it has been a good start for both students and our faculty. I am keenly aware that we have had significant issues this semester with providing our students the textbooks they needed when they needed them. To our students, I offer my personal apologies and promise that we will make this a learning opportunity to improve our processes so we don't let you down again. I do have some positive news to share as well. We have made the decision to once again offer a winter intersession. We are still in the planning stages, but you can expect to see a fairly robust set of offerings between the fall and spring semesters. More information will be released as the schedule is completed. I can't not mention that our Rams football team is undefeated with a 5-0 record and is ranked first in our division. Congratulations to the Rams football players, Coach Hoover, and his entire staff. You may also know that many of our football players were victims of a break-in of their locker rooms last month. I only bring this up because I want to personally and publicly thank the VVC Foundation for quickly responding to this unfortunate incident by restoring the cash losses of our student athletes. On behalf of our students, I want you to know that you are truly appreciated. I want to also acknowledge the efforts of the VVC Police Department, which contributed to the arrest of several suspects in the criminal activity. Another agency that deserves to be recognized is the management and board of directors of the Victor Valley Transit Authority for their generously working with the college as we move towards the establishment of a student fee to support the continuation of a bus pass program for our students. The fee was approved by the boards of trustees at September's meeting, and the fee will be collected beginning in February with the start of the spring 2015 semester. In the meantime, the Transit Authority is allowing students with a valid RAM pass to ride the bus free. Over the past few weeks, I have been conducting in-service workshops with our faculty, staff, and managers on servant leadership. This is the leadership philosophy that I have adopted and practiced for the past 21 years. It's based on the premise that to be a good leader, you have to serve first. Author and management expert Dr. Ken Blanchard, I think, says it best with his statement, "Servant leadership is about getting people to a higher level by leading them at a higher level." I've also scheduled on a monthly basis an open communication forum for all of VVC employees to meet informally and discuss topics related to improving our processes, operations, and services to students. The VVC Brain Trust, as it will be called, is a venue for any employee to bring their ideas front and center for discussion. Our faculty, staff, and management team continue to work toward full compliance with the ACCJC accreditation standards. I believe we are closing in on our compliance issues, which are by and large budget issues. We have taken a very broad approach to finding a resolution, including our recruitment efforts, course and classroom management, and dialogue with employees on several areas of cost containment. By February of 2015, we hope to have completed an evidence-based report that we will submit to the Commission demonstrating that we have a firm and sustainable plan that will bring an end to our deficit spending. At this month's Board of Trustees meeting, the Board will hear a first read on a new policy that will ban smoking on the college campus except in personal vehicles. The new policy will also allow for public safety officials to issue citations and fine violators. From the state's capital, you should know that Governor Brown signed into law Senate Bill 850, which allows a limited number of state's community colleges to pilot offering baccalaureate degrees in limited numbers of career and vocational programs. We will watch and learn as these pilot programs roll out and see where VVC programs may fit with students' needs and the established requirements for offering four-year degrees. There's been a great deal of attention given to violence and sexual assaults on college campuses nationwide in recent months, including the establishment of new reporting and training requirements. I want everyone to clearly understand that sexual assault and other acts of violence will not be tolerated at any level on our campus. The devastating effects of these crimes can last a lifetime and are in total contradiction to the values, standards, and expectations we hold for our students and our employees. Well, that about wraps it up for this month's campus update. To our faculty and staff, thank you for all the great work you do. To our students, stay focused, and above all, ask for help at the first sign you need it. And to everyone, have a safe and happy Halloween.